we are going to evaluate the integral from 0 to pi over 2 cosine squared theta d theta. Luckily, we have an identity that will take care of the cosine squared. We can reduce the power. And the identity that we can use right here, right away, is cosine squared is the same as 1 half times 1 plus cosine of 2 theta. And this is going to be much easier to integrate, okay? So we'll make that replacement first. So the 1 half will be inside, but then the number, we can bring that outside. 1 half, integral 0 to pi over 2. And then this right here will be just 1 plus cosine 2 theta d theta. And then we can integrate this. That's it. The 1 half stays on the outside. And then let me open the parentheses. The integral of 1 is theta in the theta world. And how about what's the integral of cosine? Integral of cosine is sine, okay? And the antidote of cosine is sine. So we write this down. It's plus, by the way, positive sine. And the inside will stay the same, which is sine 2 theta. But then because inside is 2 theta, the derivative of 2 theta is 2. I have to divide it by the 2. So let's put down 1 half right here. This is the antiderivative of that. Let's just verify this real quick. Derivative of theta is 1. Good. Derivative of 1 half, sine theta, sine becomes cosine, but then the 2 theta, you have to multiply by the 2. So the 2 will cancel out with the 1 half. It's okay. Anyways, all we need to do is plug in numbers, 0 and pi over 2, and we'll be done. That's it. Here, I have 1 half, and I'm going to do a long substitution right here. Plug in pi over 2 into theta, so we have pi over 2 right here, plus 1 half sine of 2 theta, 2 times pi over 2. And this right here is the first part. We have to subtract, plugging 0 into here, so this is like one of the part, okay? Plugging 0 into theta, we have 0, this is the second part. Plus 1 half sine of 2 times 0. Okay? Luckily, this is 0 and this is 0, so this is 0 altogether. And then this right here is something you can work out easily because sine of this is just pi. 2 times pi over 2 is just pi. So this is also 0. And guess what? We only have 1 half times pi over 2, which of course we end up with pi over 4 for the answer. That's it.